Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to Factorio Rails, not Robots. My name, of course, is Orbital Potato, and this is not being recorded live. This has been recorded, not live, I guess, just me by myself building a rocket. It's at 37%, and in fairness, right, I'm really very, very happy with the way that this process is going. The only thing that is slowing us down is the manufacturing of, well, rocket fuel, I suppose, to a certain degree, because we don't have absolutely tons of that, and it does take a while to manufacture. But more to the point is the fact that these rocket control units, you know, simply, you know, we don't have enough of them. We just don't have enough of them. And, the lights are flashing. We're being attacked. Have things normalized? Looks like they have been, yeah. Good, that's good. That's why we have accumulators, ladies and gents. That's why we have accumulators, so we don't get overpowered instantly. But yeah, fingers crossed things are going well. We've got extra processing units ever since, whapping the speed 3 modules into our processing plant. That is kind of good. I think that was a wise choice. We did stop manufacture of these speed modules. I can't really remember why, in all honesty. Probably because we just weren't getting enough... it was because we weren't getting enough advanced circuits to actually get to the processing unit production area. So that's why we stopped advanced circuit stuffy of that. That makes sense. You know what we could do with upgrading? We could do with upgrading all of these bad boys. What do we need? We need a little bit of iron. You know what? I'm okay with that. I can deal with getting some iron, you know. It's not the end of the world. Oh god, no. I will take speed modules, because I would, okay, I will pick them up from the belt. I will pick the circuits up from the belt, just so I don't have to manufacture them on my person. Oh man, I am so past manufacturing stuff on my person now. 99 iron gears, no thank you. I will just go and pillage the gears from the belt down here. That's right. Holy cow. See how lazy I've become since we've got this entire factory to do all of the work for us? It's disgusting, isn't it? Absolutely disgusting. But you know what? I feel that I should be allowed to do that. You know, I absolutely feel that I should be allowed to do that. Holy cow, it's going to allow us to make 10 machines just straight away. That's very, very cool indeed, actually. I like that a lot. But anyway, yes. Let's try and upgrade all of these bad boys, you know, just so that we're a little bit more on top of things. We are indeed using a lot of advanced circuits, just like I did indeed predict. It's a good thing that we have had the manufacturing for a long time now, and you know, we've sort of got used to having these guys kicking around, so to speak. Okay, whap some upgrades on here, boys. I don't know why I refer to the factories as boys, but you know, hey ho. Fingers crossed we can get some speed modules in here. That's exactly what we want to see. Perfect. Just speed module 1s at the moment. Like, I feel that we probably need a more reliable way to turn the speed module 1s into speed module 2s. I mean, we've got one speed module 2 right here. But the problem with speed module 2s is that they require such a large amount of investment. And what I mean in terms of investment, right, is I mean they need processing units. And processing units are a commodity that's... While we're not, we're not super thin on the ground in terms of processing units. You know, we've got 30. It's a nice number to have, but it's not really like the millions that we really require, so to speak. But hey ho, you know what? Perhaps we could take this opportunity to try and set up a little bit more processing unit manufacturing. Does that not sound like the most ambitious thing I've ever attempted? It sounds pretty darn ambitious, if you ask me. We'll give it a shot, but, you know, as with everything that I do, literally no guarantees. In fact, probably a guarantee that something is going to go wrong rather than something going to go right. Because, you know what, that's just what you need to expect from me. That's just what you need to expect. Something's been destroyed. A turret's been destroyed. Am I really that bothered? I'll tell you right now, I'm not really that bothered. I really don't care. I'm on a course for victory, and you cannot stop me, game. You cannot stop me, no matter how many biters you throw at me. Not strictly true. You can stop me by throwing a lot of biters at me. But I really would rather you didn't. I really would rather you didn't, actually. So please don't. Please, game, don't throw biters at me. Not interested in Mr. Bitey Bitey. No siree. And I will take one long-armed inserter. So, you know what, perhaps this could be an opportunity to make a whole shit ton more processing units, actually. I am such a genius. What a crazy, crazy fool I was to think that I couldn't make more processing units. How amazing is this? This is pretty darn amazing. And you know why it's also amazing? Is because now we'll be able to feed electronic circuits, like, straight from here onto here, if we want to. Like, I'm finding it hard to articulate what I want to say, but, you know, for example, up here, to feed this processing unit manufacturing, or this, to, okay, let me start that again, take a deep breath, potato, breathe out. Okay, I'm trying to speak too fast because I'm too excited, right? That's the entire problem. Okay, so basically, this assembly machine gets its resources from here, right? So the cutoff. So that means these two machines are not going to be feeding directly into this processing unit assembly machine. Good. But since this is lower, all of these will be feeding into this one, which means especially this one, which means that this row is never going to run out. Great. I said it, I did it, I finished it, and I made it work. I think that's important. Making it work is the most important factor, you know? I mean, top notch. Absolutely top notch. Fingers crossed we will be able to be fully keeping this processing unit manufacturing plant just set up and running. And, you know, we could actually say, hey, this place is going to be where we upgrade to the tier 2 bad boys, because we could actually take this opportunity to upgrade our units to tier 2. Holy cow. Believe it or not. Yeah, you know what? Let's manufacture more of these bad boys. Like, this is hugely convoluted, right? It's absolutely hugely convoluted, but do I have any regrets? No, of course not. Of course not. Will that long-armed inserter stretch? No, of course not. Of course not. Didn't think so. Didn't think it would. We can actually take you up now? And perhaps just do a normal inserter? Now, will you actually go into an underground belt? If you actually go into an underground belt, then we could be... In fact, no, you will go into an underground belt because I've just completely misplaced that. There we go. Okay, so this is probably the most intricate and complicated thing that I will ever do in Factorio, purely because I'm so excited about making or automating, should I say, the production of whatever you call it. What do you call it? The tier two speed modules, yeah. Although I'm worried that our advanced circuit production may not be enough. Like, it may potentially not be enough. Ah. Okay, those worries are now completely out the window because I realized that we have not been using this chest at all for probably around the last, 50 episodes. Or no, not 50 episodes, but that's an exaggeration. You get what I'm sort of coming from, don't you? I think you do. Anyway, build me one more of this, please, Mr. Game. Ugh, building the gears on me. Not ideal, but, you know, hey-ho. And fingers crossed we'll actually be able to make enough of these speed modules. Like, this might be our limiting factor. You never know. You never can tell with these things, can you? You never can tell with these things. But anyway, we're making a shit ton of processing units. Holy cow. Also, we need to make sure that we go for, the tippity-top power armor. But fingers crossed that this process will actually get us some way closer. Hopefully, anyway. We've got the alien artifacts on us, which we should probably stack up because we're not doing anything with them at the moment. So basically, here's my sort of plan. We're going to place that there, and I meant to sort of move it at the last second. I did indeed meant to do that. Yes, potato. Keep on speaking English. I'm just too excited, ladies and gents. I'm just too darn excited. So we don't actually need even... We don't even need these green bad boys. We don't even need them. We just need the red ones. The red ones, the blue ones, and the speed modules. This is simple as that. Easy. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Okay. There we go, just like so. And then... Oh, I just had a great idea. Now, will you connect up there like that? No, you don't want to be friendly, do you? I get it. You know what? Sometimes I don't want to be friendly either. But sometimes... Oh, in fact, that works perfectly. There we go. How great is that? That's darned awesome. What's the ratio we actually need? 4 to 5 to 5. Ugh, that's fine. It's not going to make that much of a difference anyway, in fairness. I'm supremely confident that we've got a ratio that works. I mean, whether it's the appropriate or most optimal ratio. In fact, I'm sure that it's not the most optimal ratio. I'm damn certain. But will it work? Of course it will. Have faith, ladies and gents. Have faith. Have some faith. Medium electric pole, please. And let's whap that down there. In fact, no, let's move you around a little bit. Stick you there. Because I do actually want to add another long-handed inserter so that we can, you know, just make filling up with advanced circuits that little bit quicker. And where do we want to output? Well, how do we make tier 3s? Let's ask that question first. Alien artifacts, annoying, but, you know, hey-ho, true. Can we just go straight into tier 3s? Can we just go straight into tier 3s? Like, is that possible? Is that even possible? Do we have enough space? I think we've got enough space. Oh my goodness, we've got enough space to go straight into tier 3s. Holy cow. Oh my goodness, this could be revolutionary. This could be amazing. Build me two more power poles, please. Okay, that goes there. Start filling you up. Let's go along a bit. Okay. And get me some more of those very, very fashionable long-armed inserters. I hear they're in these days. They're in sort of fashion sense, I suppose. Ah, yes, and suddenly we're out of advanced circuits, or processing units even, as the term actually is. Yeah, not super keen on that whole thing, I'm afraid. There we go, put them back in there. How do we counter that? The fact that we're actually still doing pretty shitty in terms of processing units. Well, I don't know, actually. I don't know. In fact, yeah, I do know. I absolutely do know. I absolutely do know. And I don't like it. I don't like it. It's a bad idea. It's a bad idea, but I love it so fucking much. Right, you know all of this iron belt that we have no need of because our factory literally, or our central bus area, literally comes to an end, like, right here? Well, why don't we just pick it all up? Right? Why don't we pick it all up? Why don't we, you know, I don't want to say let all of that hard work go to waste, but we'll let all of that hard work go to waste. Let's also take this opportunity to build a few more assembly machines right now. I don't want to be building any speed modules on me. I'll pick them up instead. Thank you very much, game. There we go. Okay, and then let's place this down instead. I mean, it's atrocious because we've just, you know, what we've done is sacrilegious. You know, we've got rid of the iron belts. We're not gonna care for iron belts anymore. What a monster I am. I mean, I was going to say what monsters we are, but you know, ladies and gentlemen of the audience, you've had nothing to do with these heinous decisions that I've been having to make. I mean, 20 electronic circuits. We need to actually rejiggle this ratio just a touch. So what we actually need is we need two long-armed inserters, and then we need one short-armed inserter. It's pretty much the ratio that we need. Okay, and then you are going to go to that side, so that... In fact, no, we're going to do something even crazier. Because this doesn't perfectly line up with this, I don't think. Alright, let's try that again. Over here. There we go. Over there. Let's get some underground pipage going on right now. Can't really go wrong with a bit of underground pipage. There we go. And move that to the side. Move that down there. And more pipage. More pipage. Boom. Do we have enough sulfuric acid, actually? We seem to have more than enough sulfuric acid. Yeah, I'm not going to worry about sulfuric acid. That's not in my remit currently. I mean, it may become my remit if we start running out of sulfuric acid, but for now, not gonna pretend like it's alright, you know? Okay. Clearly the placement of this power pole is very, very important. There we'll do fine. Now can we actually fit another processing unit area in here? I don't know if we can, quite honestly. I don't know if we can, ladies and gents, like, It's gonna be tough, but I'll try my best. Okay, let's take all of that copper line back. Now, you know, we actually do need the copper for something. We do actually need the copper for the low density structure that we're manufacturing over here. So unfortunately, we can't just, you know, completely annihilate the copper belt as well. But we can try. We can try to get it pretty much annihilated. No, I joke. We're not going to be doing anything of that ilk today. We're just actually going to be storing. I think we're probably actually just going to be storing it in chests, unless we can do something really fucking creative, like belt it out somewhere. Like not like physically like oh belt it out, just like. Where do we actually need it to go though? Like that's the real question. I mean, we've not got a single speed module 3 yet, do we? Because this dude is just not manufacturing resources quick enough. Let's give the processing unit something to mull over. That might actually help things, actually, by adding those speed module 3s in there. That may make that little bit of a difference. And alien artifacts are also going to have to be inserted, but I will do that manually through the use of a steel chest. And we'll just, I don't know, stick 34 in there for a start, I think. So, honestly, I think we're in a good position. I don't think we need to worry too much. But I'm just wondering, how can we get circuits from here, right, all the way up to this side of the belt over there? Very, 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 very confusing. I mean, what we could do is something like this. Now, hear me out. This may be seen as a little bit of a radical idea to some folk, but bear in mind, you know, all good things must come to an end. No, we're not going to do anything like super, super crazy irrational right now. Basically, we're just going to split the copper like literally onto one belt because we only need one belt of copper. We don't do anything with this second belt. In fact, I don't think we do anything with this second belt at all. No, we literally do nothing with that second belt of copper the entire way down, which is fine, you know. I mean, that doesn't really make a difference, but it just allows us near the end of the factory to clear up a little bit and have a little bit of space, I suppose. Ideally, we would like to fit a second plant in here if we can actually manage it, but that seems rather unrealistic. Although, you know, there have been stranger things. Should we try and do this? Should we try and make it super freaking mental? I'm down. I'm fucking down. Like, let's do it. Let's do it. Oh man, this is gonna become quite something. Holy cow. I mean, yes, going across there, that'll sort of work. But then where do we go after this? Do we go over here? Okay, yeah, let's go over there. Oh no, we can't. Oh, in fact, yes, we can. Of course we can. There we go. We'll go over there like that. Okay, let's just pick up that copper belt. And that means that we can actually use this dude quite effectively to make us processing units. Perfecto. And we're starting to run into some minor circuit problems, and that's with only two of the potential 4 processing unit assembly machines running. Yikes, that's worrying. We do have, however, a speed module 3. Like, that is a major success. I'm going to try something a little bit different here. I'm actually going to move this dude back by 2. And the reason that I'm going to do that is so that we can actually buffer this guy in a chest right here. So, I'm going to go like that. And we're going to say, hey, you have one pile. One pile of speed module 2s. That's it. That's all you're allowed. That's your allowance, right? All you're allowed. Get rid of that. There. Okay, perfect. So basically, once you get an entire stack of speed module 2s, it'll stop producing. It's not going to be the perfect system, but it's going to basically mean that we get speed module 3s at a super, super reduced pace rather than just no pace at all, I guess, which is kind of nice. I suppose, if that's your thing. If speed modules are your thing, then, well, I think maybe then there's an issue somewhere. But I don't know. Okay, let me get some long armed inserters. There we go. Comment down below, by the way, if speed modules happen to be your thing. Why not, eh? Why not? Hashtag join the banter bus. Comment hashtag join the banter bus if you want to join the hashtag banter bus. Down below in the comments. That's right. You heard me. I have no shame. I hashtag all day, every day. So, if, yeah, follow me on Twitter, you know. Twitter.com/@orbitalpotato. Twitter.com. That's right. The best place. Best place to go. For all of your, you know, semi-satirical, not funny needs. You know where to go. Yeah, so basically, what I'm doing is I'm just sort of pathing this underground so that we can actually connect it up to this side of the belt. So basically, these two dudes are going to be exclusive manufacturers of processing units, exclusively for the speed module 3s. Yeah, the speed module 3, so pretty much for this area only. May not actually work, but it may work. In fact, we don't even need to join them. We just have a sort of unjoined thingamajigger going right now. Okay, you can go up there, and you can go up there. And then if we plug you in, will that work a smidgen better? What do we need? We need 3 processing units. Well, why don't you take processing units? Ah, it's because we didn't have any outputs. Okay, that's cool. Well, we'll stick an output right here, I guess. Why not? And then that goes like that. Okay, so holy cow, wow. We've really, I don't want to say used and abused this area, but we've really used and abused this area. Like, really, really very, very heavily. How are we doing for circuits in or processing units in this chest? Going down. Okay, so that's important to note. So without the speed module 3s, this area goes down in circuits. Now, we don't actually need that to be... We don't actually need our very, very valuable speed module 3s to be going turbocharge overspeed in this specific area, right? We don't need that many speed module 2s. Like, that's not really that essential. We don't even need that many speed module 3s, but we seem to just be accruing them at a fairly comfortable pace now, actually. A surprisingly comfortable pace, believe it or not. But I'm fairly happy with the way things are going, to be honest. Ah, okay, we got a little bit of a problem here. Well, let me fix that problem for you, game. Once again, with one of my renowned solutions. How many advanced circuits does this chest still have? Yeah, like, literally, how many? Okay, 2k. 2k of advanced circuits. I think we're in a fairly safe situation. We're never really going to run out of them, but hey-ho. Yeah, so basically, I don't really know if I informed you of the end goal, really, of making this entire process, but basically, the more speed modules that we have, the faster we can make this process. We can make the rocket control unit process. And this is a process that we're going to be continuing in the next episode. Yeah, absolutely, 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 absolutely. Unfortunately, now it seems that we've run into another problem. We're 56% of the way to getting the rocket done, so very, very close indeed. Next couple of episodes, I would imagine, but unfortunately, it looks like rocket fuel is now our next big concern and is something that we will be dealing with in the next episode. So ladies and gentlemen, tune in then for some more Factorio Rails Not Robots. My name, of course, has been Orbital Potato. I'll see you next time. Bye.